Hello, everyone. How are we doing tonight? So, oh man, these are so good. Let's see if I can get them to come in. Focus in. There we go. Trying something different this week. Okay, so here's what I got going. I have my little, this one's a flax seed bag. I warmed it for like a minute and a half, and each time I'm working on a nail, I put it back over because it's definitely winter, and it is chilly in here tonight, and my fingers were feeling it. Okay, so tonight I am using, so I don't know if you guys have ever used the in cocoa nails, so they have them at Walmart and Ulta. They're made by Color Street. It's how Color Street started, before Color Street was Color Street. So, it's been around for ages, but now they're getting rid of it. In April, they're going to discontinue it, I believe. But this set is called Dolled Up. I had picked it up a couple years ago. I stinkin' love it. It's like, it reminds me of Havana Honey. That's one thing you'll find with the Incoco ones is you basically get the same sets. The difference is this comes with 6 strips, but they also have other ones that come with 8 that are the same, but for like $5 a set. So now, could I do just in cocoa nails? No, because they don't have near the variety, and they don't come out with new stuff constantly. But I love that set. It's like, it's definitely reminds me of Havana Honey. And tiny little bows, and I think the bows might be like a dark brown, maybe a burgundy, but I think a dark brown. Anyway, paired with Sahara Jewel, and then this is the new one from, oh, I can't think what they called that line, Candied Sugar or something sugar. Anyways, this one is Champagne Sugar. It is super stunning. It's like the holographic glitter sprinkle of Prism Break or Glitter Sweet, and then with a little bit of gold added in, and it's a stunner. And then I am also using a nail tape. So there are a couple different kinds. Well, probably even more than a couple different kinds of nail tape. These ones that come on the sheets, you can use a regular top coat on them and they're good to go, but no matter what nail tape you use, there has to be, at the very least, a couple coats of a top coat, or they're just gonna come off and be like little worms on your fingers, right? There's nothing to hold them down. They're stickers, of course, but that is not enough for day-to-day life. And then the other kind is this super thin kind that comes on little rolls. And girl, there is enough of this here that you could use it every week and probably still leave it in your will to your grandkids and have some left. Now, the only problem with this stuff that I've found is no matter what top coat I use, it pulls the color off, like makes it curl up or something. So something obviously in the top coat is not friends with this. So if I use this kind, then I have to use a clear overlay. So like this champagne one, or just even clear as day, which is Color Street's clear overlay. Okay, so under here is hiding my last three that I'm gonna do. So per usual, base coat has been on nail aid. I'm gonna take these two, pop the plastic off. And the funny thing is, like, these in cocoa nails, they even are, you know, same sizes and such, like when you buy the sets. They work 0% different for me. Okay, so I've stacked them facing each other because I want to make these into V-tips. If I was going to make them as regular slants, they could both be facing up or down, whatever, same direction. Alright, so I had seen somebody do a set like this, and they made me think, I think they had used like the creamy kind of Havana color and paired it with, I think they just used the Havana, like they just used the creamy color, but then used the nail tape, like I'm going to show you here in a crisscross way. And it made me think of a ballet slipper. And then Marcy had posted a pink set that really made me think of a ballet slipper and reminded me that I was going to try this at some point. So here we are today. So taking my first one and putting it down. Sealing down the edge. Good. And pulling that. Oh, that's hard, Jules. So lovely. So, so lovely. Okay. And then I'm going to take my dolled up. And this is pretty sheer. I don't know if you can tell. You see my finger through the back of it. Still is so cute. I don't know if I'd want to wear this as a whole nail. I feel like it would almost, you know, kind of just disappear because it is so, so soft. But with the champagne sugar and the Sahara, it is very lovely. I got these babies pretty sticky with my little heater, but they really need it right now. My hands need it, and the strips need it with this cool weather, even though we're nowhere near the kind of cool we normally are for Minnesota this time of year. Okay, so here's my little piece of nail tape. And now the trick with nail tape is you want to get it close to the edge, and then I'm running it all the way up there. But you can't have, especially if you're using like a color street overlay versus a top coat, you can't have it sticking out from under that, or it's going to, it's still going to lift up for you and it'll catch on stuff. So when I'm trimming the side here, I cut it just the smallest amount back from the edge because I want to make sure it gets covered. I don't know if this little bit is enough to go the other direction. No, it is not. Get back out there. I tried using this really thin one first, which is so lovely and dainty, but it really got lost under the glitter, so went to the next size up. I don't know, these are just, to me, they're just so pretty. They're a very delicate color and set. And they go lovely together. And I'm running it right along the line. So we're going to have the little So I lifted this just a hair so that I can snip it just a teeny bit back from where my nail actually ends. Whoop. Get off me, a little bugger. Okay, so honestly, you could stop right here with a top coat. I mean, it is so pretty. It's so pretty. But, okay, so Here's your lesson of the day for overlays. Even though we've cleaned the heck and back out of our fingers and they're super dry. I mean, look at my cuticles, look horrible because everything's so dried out. You don't want to touch the bottom of these or you're going to make fingerprints. So take it off, reattach down further. I think Shannon calls this the anchor trick. And then line up as well as you can there. Oh my goodness. Gravy. Oh, this stuff is good. I have to start hoarding that stuff. It's still in stock on their website. And I got the pink peppercorn one too. I just wish that they wouldn't have made the pink bits. So big in it. I wish they would have made it like this, like the fine glitter. I don't think they understand the value of the super fine glitters, because those big ones, you kind of lose whatever you have going underneath it or whatever. And I use my cuticle nips to make sure I'm getting everything clipped up to the nail. Okay. Seriously, I mean, how good is that? It's so dang good. It's so pretty. And this is really not my normal, like, I don't normally go with a super neutral palette. But it feels very fancy. It's good. I need to be fancy, girl, coming into 2021 with my fancy pants on. Okay. Now. Come here, little bugger. So, let's see. See how nice that lines up there. So one way you can tell if your nail strips are too cold is when you break them off on the end. They don't wrap around your nail like that. Instead, it's more like a papery tear. And if that's what's happening, your strips and nails, like hands, are too cold. And throw that little rice bag on your nail strips. And you don't want it, you know, you don't want it heated for 3 minutes steaming hot. But you can heat it for like a minute and a half and it makes a world of difference. Also makes them very, very sticky. Oh, gosh. I'm glad I have another half of this set because, like, I really do think I've had it for over a year. I bet close to 2 years. And I could not, like, I kept going back and forth on it. Do I love this? Do I hate it? Nope. For real, officially, I love it. And I think, like, I'm already thinking next time, maybe I'll do it with, like, a burgundy, but, oh, Sahara's so stinking good with it. Okay, get off there. All right, so here we are, which also, again, skip the nail tape and stop right here, and it's so pretty. I don't know if that's... Is it focusing? Can never tell. Yeah. I mean, really, that is so good, just like that. Gosh. But don't skip the nail tape, girl. Go the extra mile. Always go the extra mile. Have something to entertain ya. Okay. and I'm going to the corner, but not, can you tell? It's like not all the way to the corner, because I want this champagne sugar to be able to cover that up and trap it so it doesn't get crazy on me. I will say, if you have a nail tape that you can use a top coat on, top coat works better because it's a lot easier to kind of, you know, flood around the edges and that kind of thing, and to get it, you know, really trapped in there. But, honestly, I have, like, stalked the Color Street page on Facebook, and if not more than once a month, chanted for Prism Break, which I don't know if you know it or not. I don't know if you've used it. They did it as a limited thing. Also, it was like an accent pack. So you only got four of them and you had to spend, I don't know, $40 or something irritating to even get a darn pack of it. Right? And it's so good. It's like these, like that perfect amount of just the softest glitter overlay. So good. Okay, so I ranted about Prism Break. And then this year, they put out Glitter Suite with the holidays. And I legitimately hoarded that. I think I have 15 sets of it. I don't feel bad. I'll probably have more before it's gone. Do not feel bad about hoarding what you love. Because I'll tell you what does make you feel bad is when you run out of it. And they never do it again. Instead, they bring back something stupid that you didn't want to see. Maybe that's just me. Okay, again, you could stop right here. You could have stopped one of them. Could have hit none of them, and it looks beautiful, but these, I'm telling you, if you have not gotten, now what's this called again, champagne sugar, if you haven't gotten it, you better get it, because it really is, it's a limited one, it's gonna be gone soon. Word on the street, on the nail street. Okay, I'm going to show you real quick here. So you see this didn't make my, just the very, very tip. So I pulled off the side of that one because I always have overhang over there. And I'm doctoring it by putting that right on the very, very tip of mine. So that the whole thing, and I'll just fold it over. In morning, it will be totally set, and that way, that's safe. Okay, back to what I was saying. Word on the nail street is that now, this year, 2021, as we're already kicked off in it, and maybe you guys have noticed, from now on, they're going to try to do, like, 19, which 19 seems like a lot when I think about it. It's, you know, I guess it's probably, I bet it's at least once a month, plus holidays, they'll do small releases, like this sugar one, where you got just a few sets to pick from, and what was the other one they just did, where you got Dallas Darling and those to pick from, all the blues, which I only liked one of those, Dallas Darling, and really, it looks like how sweet it is, so I didn't even step too far out of my comfort zone today. But I am a fan of that, of doing small releases. Now, I will say there's one catch to those small releases, if you're asking me, is, girl, you better have enough in stock for more people to order than just stylists, because I feel like a lot of times the stylists, I mean, it's good that they're able to get them so that we can get them from them. But I want to be able to go on there and do my own order so that A, I'm getting the my loyalty card stamped, because then that's going to earn me free sets. And B, I want to do my buy one, get one free, right? So they have now finally bumped it up so that you can order 8 sets of things. For a long time, they were at a limit of 2, and then they went to 3, and now they went to 8. So I feel like they've finally gotten stuff under control. They did a lot of new machines and factory and stuff. Again, let me say, I'm not a stylist. But I read everything I can on it because I love them. And for 2 years now, I have continually had my nails done because I love them. And me and my bestie Marce, 2 years in even, spend a ridiculous amount of time talking about sets and such. Because I'm a little bit obsessed, that's all. Girl, you gotta be obsessed with something. Okay, so, here we go. Now, don't mind these dried up looking cuticles. They'll look better tomorrow. This isn't a good nail prop, is it? Scissors, but it's going to pretend to be. Those are amazing. Like, even more amazing than I thought they were going to be. I love it when things go even better than I had anticipated. Now, I don't remember what I was saying, so it's not that important. Anyway, there we go. The next video I do was a request by Mindy, and I had kind of had it on my radar, and then she brought it up, and I thought, yep, I better do it then. She wants a tour of the tools. So, it's true, I do have a lot of tools going. So I'm going to do that. And I think what I'll do is I'll remove my nails, come in with bare nails, and use up some spares I have floating around just to show you how the different stuff works, because I have a load of different punches, craft punches, fancy cut scissors, that kind of stuff. Plus, I'll show you the stuff that I feel like is a necessity in your nail kit, right? So anyway, that'll be coming up next, which today's Saturday. I'll probably change these Wednesday or Thursday night. Like, sitting here looking at them right now, I say I don't ever want to take them off. I am obsessed, in love with them. But guaranteed, in 2 days, I'm going to go, yep, I love these. But now I have something better in mind. Also, they released the Valentine's Day stuff. You order them on Monday. You can order them on Monday. There was a couple I thought were pretty cute. I'm not big into heavily arted sets, but a couple of them were pretty cute, and I have some ideas for those. But I also think it'd be fun to do some Valentine's nails using what we have. So they'll be inspired and give the nod towards Valentine's Day without being super crazy overly done. So, anyway, if you haven't got champagne sugar, get on it, because it's amazing. And the pink peppercorn is really good. And then also, if you like purple, which I'm not a purple person, so you just really will never see a purple theme on my channel. But they have one called, oh man, lavender something or lilac something. It's the finest purple glitter. It's pretty. It makes me want to use it, but I don't love purple. And then Sahara Jewel, amazing. And then this was the In Cocoa set, dolled up. So, have a great night, and we'll see everybody in a few days.